Welcome. My name is Ibo van der Poel, professor in ethics and technology. Today's lecture is about what is innovation. I will discuss four topics with you. First, what is innovation? Second, incremental versus radical innovation. Third, does responsible innovation require radical innovation? And fourth, are new more issues raised by radical innovations? Let us start with the definition given by Jeroen van der Hoven in the earlier lecture of innovation. In his lecture, he defined innovation as an activity or a process which may lead to previously unknown designs pertaining either to the physical world, think of infrastructures, buildings, the conceptual world, for example, frameworks, conceptual frameworks, mathematics, logic, theory, software, or to the institutional world, like social and legal institutions, procedures and organizations, or to combinations of these. And when implemented, these expand the set of options. In today's lecture, I will focus specifically on technical innovation. Now, technical innovation comes in different sorts. An often made distinction is that between product innovation on the one hand and process innovation on the other hand. A product innovation is an improvement in the product design. A process innovation, on the other hand, pertains to the production process. So, a new mobile phone is a product innovation. But a new assemblage technology for mobile phones is a process innovation. Another distinction that's often made is that distinction between incremental and radical innovations. Now, innovations can be radical in a number of ways. They can be based on new operational principles. They can be based on new scientific knowledge. They can offer new functionalities. They can reach out to new user groups. Or they may serve new types of values. Here, in this lecture, we will focus on a taxonomy for innovation that was developed by Abernathy and Clark in 1985. This taxonomy classifies innovation along two axes. The first axis is whether the innovation is based on existing knowledge or whether it requires new knowledge. The second axis is whether the innovation is intended for current users or for new users. Now, radical innovation typically both is aimed at new markets and at new market and new knowledge. Now, if you combine these two axes that we saw, we have four quadrants, as shown on this slide. And let me briefly discuss the different kinds of innovation. So first we have regular or incremental innovation. And this builds on existing knowledge and aims at existing customers. A typical example is the new model of a mobile phone, like they are developed every year or so. A second type of innovation is niche innovation. And this builds on existing knowledge, but it reaches out to new customers or to new markets. A typical example is a GPS device for cycling. Now, revolutionary innovation, the third type, is aimed at existing customers, but based on new knowledge. An example are electric cars. And then we have the fourth type, architectural innovation, based on both new knowledge and opening up new markets for the innovator. An example are fertilizers and agricultural mechanization. Now, there are a number of typical examples of architectonal innovation. These are, for example, the T-Ford, the television, the first jet aircraft, the fertilizers, the internet, smart grids and smart cities, and nanotechnology, the promise for the future. Now, all these architectonal innovations have a number of characteristics. First, they only occur once in a while. Second, they lay the base for a range of more incremental innovations. And third, they destroy existing knowledge and existing market relations. As a consequence of this, they are often initiated by outsiders. These are new companies or companies that were established in other domains. Think, for example, of Apple that enters the mobile phone market through the smartphone. Now, I can turn to one of the central questions of this web lecture. And this question is, does responsible innovation require radical innovation? Now, to answer this question, let us first look at the definition of responsible innovation that was given in a previous lecture. It says, responsible innovation is the innovation that, when implemented, expands the set of options for solving a more problem. Now, all the four types that we discussed can expand the set of options for action. And all types can therefore be responsible. Still, responsible innovation will, I hold, often require radical innovation. Why do I think so? Now, to acquire responsible innovation, we need to take into account values in the design process. And often, we will need to take into account values that were not addressed before in the design process. Now, taking into account just new values often also requires new knowledge. So, take the example of we want to take into account privacy in the design of smart meters. And then we need to know what privacy is. We need knowledge about privacy. And we also need knowledge about how to translate privacy into the design of smart meters. This slide shows some of the controversy about smart meters. Now, if we take into account new values like privacy, this may also have an effect on the relation with users. It means an extension of the functional requirements met by the previous design. So, responsible innovation may change the relation with customers and may mean new markets and new functionalities. So, this all taken together suggests that responsible innovation will often be like what we have called architectural innovation. Of course, to see whether this is really the case, more empirical research is needed. But if it were true, it would have some interesting implications that I want to discuss with you. So one thing is that existing companies are not always the best suited to introduce responsible innovation. And instead, the initiative might come from outsiders or from newcomers. We will see some of these implications and some of examples of this in the fourth web lecture of this week. I now want to turn to a final issue in this web lecture. And that's the question, do radical innovation introduce new ethical issues? And I will argue that it does. Now, why do I think so? The reason is that radical innovation is not about doing things in a new way, but it is about doing new things. Think of the internet, think of smartphones, air transport, prenatal diagnostic techniques. All these technologies create new options for action. And in doing so, they also raise new ethical issues. Think of the privacy issues faced by the internet. Or think of prenatal diagnostic techniques. Suddenly, we can predict how likely it is that a child will have a certain disease. A disease that can perhaps not be cured. And this raises completely new ethical issues for parents. What should they do? Should they consider an abortion? Now, for existing technologies, there are often more habits and more rules. And in case of incremental innovation, these rules and habits are usually still adequate. But in the case of radical innovation, they are often no longer sufficient. An example of this is the introduction of the jet engine in civil aviation. This was a radical innovation. But not very long after the jet engine had been introduced, two such airplanes with the name Havilland Comet, they crashed. Well, why did it happen? The problem was not the engine themselves, but the problem was the fact that jet-powered planes flew much higher. Therefore, the cabin had to be pressurized to make flying comfortable for the passengers. As a result of this, some points of the fuselage were subject to greater stresses than before. This led to metal fatigue and ultimately to disaster. So, this all brings me to a hypothesis I would like you to think about. And this hypothesis is as follows. Responsible innovation often requires radical innovations, which in turn often raise new ethical issues. Thanks for your attention.